This is qualification.
Hello guys, my name is Irhamni Malika and I'm here with my friends.
Hello, I am Anissa Zahara.
Hello, I'm Ofranina Sinta.
Hi, I'm Aulia Urahma.
Hi, my name is Amira Adila.
And hi, my name is Malika Sari Idris.
In this video, we will show you about Aceh traditional food. If you want to know more, just keep on watching.
Doesn't know about this popular Indonesian traditional food. Mie Aceh is a spicy noodle dish with sliced beef or seafood such as shrimp, crab, and squid. Basically, Chinese noodles are usually served in savory and spicy curry soup. The name Mie Aceh is taken from its original region, Aceh, because its distinctive taste is different from other noodle dishes in Indonesia. In the manufacturing process, Aceh noodles use distinctive noodles with thick and flat sheets. Unlike other noodles, the color of Aceh noodles tends to be bright yellow, adding beauty to the dish. The spice used is a kind of curry spice, which is a special spice that gives a distinctive taste in this one culinary dish. On its presentation, Aceh noodles are served in three types, namely fried noodles, soup noodles, and red fried noodles. Format that is used can be adjusted to our taste because it won't reduce the taste and deliciousness of the noodle. So, don't worry! Complementary menus in serving Aceh noodles can usually be eaten to fried onions, crackers, cucumbers, and also lime. What is unique about this food is that the additional ingredients used are beef, mutton, or seafood. In general, there are many Indonesian noodle dishes that use chicken meat as an additional ingredient in serving the noodles. In addition, the soup used is a thick and savory curry sauce. Usually, noodle dishes in Indonesia tend to use clear and soft broth. So that's what makes Mie Aceh is the most unique among other noodle dishes in Indonesia. In its development, Mie Aceh has become one of the very popular culinary delights, so that this dish can be found in roasted style in Aceh. This culinary is highly recommended if you visit Aceh. Many say it's incomplete when visiting Aceh without tasting this one typical dish. So, for you noodle lovers, what are you waiting for? Let's try this one. Thank you.
You can leave a country without eating chicken wherever you travel. The delicious ayam tangkap will be a dish you must try at least once. The fried local fowl is uniquely presented with aromatic fried greens such as curry and pandan leaves. The diced chicken is cooked with turmeric, shallots, ginger, garlic, and tamarind water, then deep fried until it's crispy. This wine culinary is the typical culinary cuisines of Aceh. The habit of eating chicken catch has become part of the culture of the people in Aceh. The processing of chicken is not hard. It is only by frying the chicken that previously have been given a savory seasoning that when eaten. Spices that used are like garlic, pepper, nutmeg, salt, and ginger. One season and fry chicken about 5 to 10 minutes. At the same time, also include a few handfuls of leaves that will be served with the chicken, so that the flavor of spice foliage helps sink into the meat of chicken. The leaves that are used are including curry leaves, pandan leaves, peas, and grating koja. The leaves are later covered dish of chicken catch on a stack of plates. Unlike other chicken dishes, ayam tangkap is served with a mixture of pandan and basil leaves that are fried with the chicken. The leaves give an extra kick to the dish. This may look like your typical fried chicken dish, but the combination of green chili and tamarind leaf or curry leaves surely turns this into something else. So, this must be a must try for you as a chicken lover. Aceh traditional coffee or cup coffee is the other most popular dish originally from Aceh. Right, as one of the biggest coffee producing regions in Indonesia, it is not surprising that Aceh has a high quality of coffee. One of the best types that Aceh has is Gayo coffee. What is the typical of Gayo coffee itself is its processing. So, as to produce coffee with a sharp taste and interesting fragrance, the way to drink coffee is blown in advance in order that the liquid of coffee doesn't seep out of the glass. Coffee with this dish is known as kopi kop, or in Indonesian means kopi tertelungkup. The special kopi kop dish is actually famous in the area of Ujung Karang village, West Aceh Regency. As we all know that kopi kop originated from the homeland of the national hero Tengku Umar, specifically in Melaboh, West Aceh. Apparently, not only now, the people there have been preparing this kopi since the times against the Dutch colonialism. The process only takes 3 minutes. First, put in coffee grounds, then stir it out with hot water. After that, it is immediately reversed. The process is very simple. Everyone can do it by their own self. In order to stay awake and to introduce the coffee to the people, so until now this coffee continues to be developed. Once you order the coffee, drink a sip and then left to roll at sea, so that the coffee is still warm and it's not polluted by dust and dirt. So the glass is turned over. When the coffee bean returns after fizzing in the sea, they can still enjoy the coffee again. Placement of a straw in a glass cup is to make it easier to drink coffee for women. Usually women are rather difficult if they have to drink coffee directly from the coffee plate, so a straw is provided. And the placement of the straw is basically clamped in a glass. The straw used must also be a soap old production straw, the amateur straw like most. So, if you want to enjoy the unique sensation of drinking coffee, go try kopi kop. The aroma and flavor of its robusta certainly makes you don't want to taste just for once. For those who don't like the bitter taste of coffee, you can mix it with milk or almond sugar. For additional information, the price of this coffee is from 8,000 rupiah to 12,000 rupiah for one glass. As for the other types of cup coffee, there are three types. There are original cup coffee, milk cup coffee, and chocolate milk cup coffee. In addition, there are also types of Arabica coffee serving, ranging from espresso, espresso singer, Americano coffee latte, and other coffees. If you fall into the race with coffee cup, let's visit Aceh and taste that special coffee. Believe it, you will not regret, and maybe you don't feel enough to taste it just for once. Salak Pliu is one of the Aceh's traditional culinary, which is still much in demand by Acehese people as a snacks. No wonder why so many entrepreneurs look at it as a promising alternative to the family economy. Nowadays, Salak Pliu has been known in various places outside of Aceh to overseas, such as Malaysia. Many travelers from this neighbor country buy Salak Pliu and brought them home to give it for their relation. This culinary is a hereditary recipe from the ancestor, made from salak fruit that has been chopped and soaked with salt water for 12 hours, then mix it up with pliu. Pliu is a typical Acehese spice made from coconuts, which already have been cured and mixed roughly, then dried in the sun to dry. In addition, pliu is used as a spice for cooking vegetable to be made into curry. Vegetable used such as young malinja fruit, malinja leaves, long beans, peanuts, and jackfruits, and papaya, bamboo shoots, and young eggplants. Acehese also have their own way to enjoy the pliu by becoming a snack material that is eaten with fresh fruit such as salak. This Aceh snack is very easy to find at the moment. Many new traders are trying to sell salak pliu and they get a lot of profit. The snakes are widely sold on the side of the road at low prices, and it can be found in the Jerusalem area where many students study in there. So if you get a chance to visit Aceh, don't forget to try salak pliu. Rujak Aceh. Rujak Aceh can be found when you just arrive in the city of Bandar Aceh, which is located in Wan Bintang Street, close to the Iskandar Muda Flight Airport. This special culinary is loved by many various people, ranging from children to adults. One of the places that we visited was Rujak Cupit, and many families visit it to enjoy Rujak Aceh when the holiday is coming and to enjoy the views of the surrounding village that can be so relaxing. Rujak Aceh can already be found in other provinces in Indonesia, but it is not complete when revisiting the Aceh city that has the epithet of Surami Mekah. We have seized the typical culinary Aceh, which is Rujak Aceh. Rujak Aceh offers a distinctive taste with a mixture of rumbia, mango, guava, yam, pineapples. These offerings are put into ulekan or cobek, then stir it with plum sugar until it blends, then add chili and salt to taste and sprinkle fried peanuts. Different from other salad, Rujak Aceh offers a refreshing taste. This is due to a mixture of rumia fruit containment. And one portion of Rujak Aceh, 2 up to 3 grains of rumia are usually included. In addition to making Rujak Aceh more special, the content of the rumia fruit itself has many health benefits for the body. It has been mixed into Rujak Aceh. The taste of the astringent produced by rumia will produce a distinct taste on your tongue that blends with other special fruit. So yummy! To enjoy this typical Aceh salad, we can find it in its original place. Many say Rujak Aceh was originally the food of the Acehese warriors of the past when fighting the invaders, and the soldiers used the fruit to be consumed at the moment when they were fighting. So, you should try Rujak Aceh too!
guys, those are Aceh culinary food. If you want to visit Aceh one day, don't forget to taste our culinary foods. So, thanks for watching. See you, bye-bye.